Hello, and welcome to Late Night with Keish Lorraine. That is me. Do not, I have a very special person. You know, I barely tolerate most people, but this one, I will accept it to my circle. Hello, baby.
Well, hello, Keish. Thank you so much for having me tonight.
Thatari. Welcome, Thatari. Let's get down to the obligatory questions before we get down to the meat.
Yes, let's.
How did we come up with our name?
It's not a secret that I'm a very big nerd. I play Dungeons & Dragons, and my stage name is actually one of my longtime favorite character names. That's how I got my drag name.
What kind of nerd character did you play?
She was a scion. She telekinetically, psychically controlled people. So she had all your charisma, but my good looks.
How long have you been doing drag?
I started drag the first Monday of November 2019. So just over 4.5 years.
Do you have any inspiration? Why did you want to start doing this? What started it?
I one night saw Anastasia Alexander performing Holy Water. And I said, I want to do that. Well, not that, but something like that. Because she's acrobatic and she can own that stage. I can't.
I want to see you do that.
If I get on the floor, there's probably a problem.
me too. You'll probably hear 1,000 things creaking and breaking right at the same time. But I understand that. I've seen her do that, and it's amazing.
It is. She's so great. Other inspirations, of course, Morphine Drip, my drag mother. Mm-hmm. Sweet Tea, the former host of Monday Night Madness at Court Austin.
Darling.
Ginger Minj from the RuPaul's Drag Race.
Never seen it.
She calls herself a glamour toad. And so I identify with that.
She's toad?
Kind of toad. You know, she's kind of short, round.
Oh.
Lots and lots of makeup. She's a cross dresser for Christ. Yeah.
Your face. That's a real thing.
She claims it is.
Oh.
And then I think also.
Let's see what the Baptists think about that one.
Oh, yes. And then I think also Mrs. Kasha Davis, because I like her sense of humor.
Don't know that one either. Not impressed. Now, this does impress me because this is something I do not know. I do not understand the technologies out there.
Okay.
But you make your own mixes.
I do. Well, I try.
Well, explain that. How does one make a mix?
There's this technology called software. And you put it on a computer, and then you can take bits of music and audio clips and mix them together and make a mix. The way I usually come up with my ideas for a mix is I will hear a song or see a video or something, and I'll think, I want to do something based around that. And then I build the idea out from there. So an example is for Monday Night Madness, I did a Karen mix where the idea started with a song called Heads Will Roll by the Yeah Yeah Yeahs. And I took that and built around that and came out with an entire song built around a nature documentary about a Karen.
And I believe that is the number you're going to perform.
It is. It is. Although I'm sorry to report that someone has stolen your head.
Well, in case you don't know what we're talking about, the first time Thatari performed this little number, she thought she would be a cutesy pootsy and pull out a severed head that looked like moi. The crowd loved it. I was not amused.
But it looked just like you.
Besides that little incident, I do not give out the compliments often.
No, you don't.
But I do believe you are very talented.
Thank you.
I will probably never say that in public again.
I wouldn't expect you to.
But I believe this is a moment we can pause.
Okay.
When and let you toddle off and get ready for your number.
Okay.
And then after your number, we will convene and continue our little interview. Good?
Sure.
Good, good. So let's let Thatari go off and prepare, and we'll be right back.
The Complainous Americana, or better known as the North American Karen. Karens may appear to be quiet and unassuming, They're one of the most dangerous creatures on the planet.
It's Karen!
I want to speak to your
manager!
I'm gonna win ya, I'm gonna get you one way or another. I'm gonna see ya, I wanna meet ya one day. Maybe next week I'm gonna meet ya, I'm gonna meet ya, I'll meet ya.
Minimus Wages, the Karen's natural prey. Yeah! He unassumingly walks into the Karen's vast territory. The Karen adjusts her posture. Now fully erect, unlike her husband, she's ready to strike. The Karen attacks with full force. Karens stun their prey with a variety of techniques, causing chaos and confusion. She's used to dominating, and today is no different. Minimus Wages never stood a chance.
Who is the manager of this fucking shit all?
For undeserved respect is satisfied for now.
That was wonderful. I'm so impressed.
Well, thank you.
Yeah, I feel this way, and you don't have to say this, but do you think your talent gets ignored?
I have gone through a long period of time where I felt like I was not being seen. Yes, I feel like that has changed in the last 6 months or so. I still feel like amateur performers need to know that they are seen and that their performances are appreciated.
I can agree with that. Yes. Now let's get to the Barbara Walters moment of the show. We have talked about this, and you recently lost someone.
Yes, I did.
Do you want to talk about that person?
Sure. Back on Halloween, I lost the person that raised me, my aunt, Pam. She was one of my biggest supporters, and she never got to go see me in person. But a couple weeks before she passed, she wanted to see some of my drag performances, and I showed her some videos. We watched a couple of my favorites, and she really enjoyed this one that I did for a competition called Ghoul School that was themed for science fiction. And we both share a love for Doctor Who. So I made a mix as well. Yes. I made a mix for Doctor Who, and I built a life-sized TARDIS prop to put on stage so that I could come out of. And it even opened up, and inside, it was bigger on the inside than it was on the outside. I was so happy. It looked a little rough, but I learned a lot of things from that process. And that's what Ghoul School is about. It's a workshop. It's not just a competition. Although there's a winner, the real prize is perfecting your art.
You can tell me if I'm wrong, but aren't you a darling of the Ghoul School? Aren't you kind of a big cheese there?
No, I wouldn't say a big cheese. I usually film as many of the Ghoul School competitions as I can because I think that everyone should be able to see themselves on stage.
I'm glad you talked about your aunt.
Yes.
That's
the Karen number that I made for the final Monday Night Madness finale. Actually has some of her clothing in it and her favorite colors. So
it's
an homage to her.
Oh, well, the Quiche likes that. You film a lot.
I do.
Do you ever feel, like while you're filming something, do you ever think, I wish I was on the other side of the camera?
Frequently, yes.
Which show do you wish you could be in that you always feel?
I always love the knockout competitions. The idea of knockout is five or six competitors are given a series of three challenges, and they perform these challenges to a theme, say like colors of the rainbow. Everyone picks a color and does a number.
But
and
haven't we done one of those together?
Did we do it? I did green. And
I totally forgot.
Red, if I'm not mistaken, because why not?
I have a lot of that.
Yes, you do.
Take the easy way out. That's right. What I always say.
I came out in a green gown that I'd put some rhinestones on.
I remember now.
And a green mohawk.
Yes. Little Shop of Horrors.
Yes.
I remember now. I have no clue what I did that night.
I'll have to find the video.
I do not remember. It just now came to me. Tell us about your YouTube channel.
Oh, yes. We talked about me recording videos. I actually started recording drag videos because I was too broke to be able to tip. And I wanted to give something back to the entertainers. So I started recording and then posting them sending them on Facebook Messenger. Then Facebook Messenger decided it was not going to allow my new phone to send the files because they were too big. So I started uploading them to YouTube, and that just kind of took off from there. And I've got somewhere over 150 videos at least. I think we're approaching 200 now from just the last year, maybe 2 years.
Sorry.
That's okay.
I just had a wiener. Now, are you ready? It's time for the Quiche Questionnaire. Are you ready?
Yes.
Question one. Describe your drag style in one word.
Kooky.
If you were to write a book about your life, what would it be?
Well, here we are. The life and times of a diva.
Your wig flies off during a performance. What do you do?
Well, like you, I wouldn't know. I've never had a wig unintentionally come off.
Best advice you've ever received.
There's so much of it. Contour, corset, and wig glue.
Final question. You're only allowed to listen to one song for the rest of your life. What would it be?
Godsmack's Voodoo.
Ooh. Why?
It brings back fond memories.
Oh, good. Well, I've ran out of cards, so I guess that means we're done.
Yay!
Thank you for coming, sweet baby darling.
Thank you so much for having
me. You really are my favorite. I'll tell the others that too, but right now you're my favorite.
I appreciate it. I will always remember this.
No, you won't. Thank you for watching Late Night with Quiche the Ray. We'll see you next episode. Good night, baby darling.